What WilkinsonEyre are interested in that visitors to this gallery should get is the sheer wonder of actually all, not just the objects and the technology, but in a way, a kind of emotional connection, the human experience of medicine. And you get it all here.
The first thing the visitors will come across, 3-metre-high bronze statue by Mark Quinn. Fantastic focal point, creates the first vista, can be seen kind of right from the other side of the Eastern Hall. That this really puts the visitor and the human body right at the front of the narrative.
So we have stripped back to the basic architecture. So things that in a sense were superfluous and somehow didn't look as if they belong. We've taken a lot of things out, but one of the other things we've done is let the daylight in. So you get these changes in pace from light to dark. You bring the outside world into the space. Don't think it should always be about sort of removing people from reality. It shouldn't always be black box.
One of the key things was create these vistas that would draw the visitors through the spaces. And we spent a lot of time placing objects open display or kind of lighting them dramatically or having mass displays to draw people across. I think that's particularly important when you get to the void over the Making Modern World and you actually kind of see right across the gallery and are kind of drawn in by large scale AV or amazing objects.
We're trying to turn, in a sense, what's 3 galleries into one gallery. So we're going through a sequence of spaces, and in the middle of them was a big array of lifts. And it was fundamental as to how we could make the two main parts of the gallery feel connected. And I think we've really succeeded with that in a number of ways that we've done it. One is having a unifying floor finish running through this rather beautiful wooden floor. And the other is to actually cloak the lifts in a whole range of objects. They act as sort of partly to terminate vistas, but also to take you on to the next thing. So it feels, you feel there's a continuity here, which I think at the outset looked quite difficult, but we were always thinking about it.
With this being an object-rich gallery, one of the challenges was how to display the cases with the appropriate environmental conditions that they all require, but also without creating a barrier between the visitor and the objects. The design of the display cases had their technical challenges, but we've used non-reflective glass, practically frameless, and so you get close and personal with the objects. Another key element was communicating the themes to the visitor. We've got a lot of objects and a lot of different themes. So we worked very close with the interpretation team and the graphic design team and came up with a kind of graphical hierarchy of totems which work as signals as you go through the galleries, probably highlighting a particular section focus object or even key objects within the narratives. At the far western end of the gallery, we have another threshold space. The look and the feel of this space was in contrast to the other spaces. It's meant to feel kind of quite intimate and a kind of certain space where you can sit and kind of think about all the stories you've come across in your journey through the other galleries.
If we design this right, if we get this right in every way that we can, that the gallery will last 20, 25 years and that you'll come in 20 years' time and it'll still look quite fresh. And if we can do that, then I think we've really achieved something.